Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding 2016 the Supreme Court's report card written by Suhirt Parthasarthi. Now this topic relates to the balance between the judiciary, executive and the legislature. This highlights about the important achievements of the Supreme Court, the areas in which it has not performed well, and about how it has entered into a conflict with the government. Now this topic is important for political science, public administration optional students, plus this will also help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Now before we understand the positives and the negatives done by the Supreme Court this year, we need to know about Montesquieu's theory of balance. Now, Montesquieu, he was a French political thinker who has theorized on the theory of balance. Now, according to Montesquieu, there are three organs of the state. One is legislature, the other is executive, and the third organ of the state is the judiciary. Now these three organs, they work in coordination with each other. These three organs, they have been allocated specific work and function that they should be performing. These three organs keep a kind of balance between each other, balance by generating accountability and control from each other. So these three organs, they don't operate in vacuum. There is a kind of a relationship existing amongst these three organs. And this relationship is a relationship of accountability. This relationship is a relationship of control. And what is the basis of control? What is the basis of accountability? This is very, very important. Now we have constitution as the main thing. Constitution is the basis of these three organs. Constitution reflects the vision of a nation, vision of a country. Constitution is the soul as per which these three organs should be functioning. So these three organs, they generate accountability and control as per the conscience. As per the conscience and the spirit of the constitution. Spirit of the constitution. Constitution has specifically defined what are their specific and definite domains. How they should be performing their roles. Now, if the judiciary would not be performing its role, it would lead to despotism on the part of executive. It would lead to despotism on the part of legislature. Now, both these organs in the absence of judiciary will tend to usurp powers. They will tend to disregard the freedoms that has been mentioned specifically in the constitution. The fundamental rights that has been accorded to the people. The judiciary actually keeps a check that nothing such is done by the executive and the legislature that is ultra vires to the constitution. Now coming back to this year. Now this year has been a year in which the conflict has taken place between the executive and the judiciary. Now executive believes that judiciary is trying to usurp its role that has been defined in the constitution. According to executive, judiciary is not performing its role that it should be performing. It is overreaching its role. We have seen in Indian setup, in order to be more responsive to the social demands, judiciary has engineered certain kind of judicial instruments. Now what instruments I am talking about? Instruments like public interest litigation. Instruments like special leave petition. Judiciary has designed these social innovations, judicial innovations, in order to address the grievances of the people. In order to open the doors of judiciary wide. In order to make accessibility of the judiciary to the people. Now such kind of judicial innovations have not been welcomed by the executive, because the executive believes that public interest litigation, it is not in consonance with the Montesquieu's theory of separation of powers, Montesquieu's theory of generating balance or instituting balance, because through PAEL it is the judiciary which suo moto also takes up the social issues, and judiciary tend to order the executive or the legislature to perform certain specific roles. Judiciary's main function is just to adjudicate. Judiciary's main function is not to execute. Judiciary's main function is not to legislate. But judiciary is trying to overreach its function. Judiciary has resorted to judicial activism, and 2016 has seen something very new: judicial overreach. Judiciary coming out with rules, judiciary coming out with regulations, judiciary coming out with laws. In the case of banning of the diesel vehicles, in the case of NEET issue that was related to the admission to the medical colleges. Now another example of judicial overreach was about correcting and resurrecting good governance in the cricket, and for that judiciary has been very vocal against BCCI, and it has set up a committee under Lodha panel, and this very Lodha committee has recommended that what should be the constitution of the BCCI. Now BCCI is forcing a law is being forced on BCCI by the judiciary. So this is a cause of judicial overreach. But there has also been instances where judiciary has not been able to uphold the freedom of the people. Judiciary has taken a back step in protecting the rights of the people. ये नहीं है कि judiciary ने हमेशा overreach ही किया 2016 में. कुछ ऐसे cases भी हैं, like Indian Penal Code का section 499 and section 500. Now both these sections, they relate to criminal defamation. And criminal defamation, it directly impinges on the right to freedom of expression and speech, freedom of expression, right to freedom of expression and speech. And this right, prima facie, at the face itself, is very draconian. It hits at the fundamental right. But judiciary has failed to look at this specific section from this perspective. It has taken its own perspective, the perspective of the right of recognition in the society. If somebody is hitting at the recognition of the society, at the respect of the society in the person, that person should be prosecuted under section 499 and section 500, that is criminal defamation. Agar aapki awaaz, aapke bol, aapka expression kisi ki izzat ko kharab karta hai jo usne kafi saalon se kamai hai, to you will be liable to be prosecuted. So basically It is not respecting the freedom of expression and speech. Reality में होना क्या चाहिए? एक democracy में सबको बोलने का हक होना चाहिए. अगर किसी की इज्जत खराब हो रही है किसी के बोलने से, तो वो इज्जत ही बहुत shallow है. अगर कोई अपनी इज्जत किसी के criticism करने से वो नहीं बचा पा रहा है, it means that particular recognition, that particular respect is not defendable, it is actually shallow. So in this case, it has taken a back step in protecting the rights of the people. Now we have another case with respect to demonetization. In the demonetization, judiciary has failed to address the concerns of the various petitioners. So it has taken a back step like it has taken in the case of Aadhaar. Now why judiciary has done this? Judiciary may have taken a retrograde step of not respecting the rights of the people because judiciary feels that executive and legislature wants to enter into the domain of judiciary by setting up an objective and democratic way of appointing the judges. National Judicial Appointment Commission. Now, National Judicial Appointment Commission was a democratic way of appointing the judges by the involvement of the legal experts, by the involvement of the judiciary, by the involvement of the executive. But this has been called as ultra vires to the constitution. So this, such cases like the case of 499500 and the case like demonetization, the case like Aadhaar, they at the face appears to be nothing less than appeasing the executive, appeasing the legislature and showing reverence to the executive and the legislature so that they don't exert, so that they don't enter in the domain of the judiciary. Judiciary wants to keep itself isolated. There are cases of nepotism in judiciary. There are cases of quarterization in judiciary. There are cases by which judiciary wants to keep itself enveloped from the pressures of the executive and the legislature. So this was all for the editorial. Now what kind of question you can get on this particular editorial? The question could be like, critically analyze the relationship between the executive, legislature and the judiciary. Critically analyze how National Judicial Appointments Commission might endanger the freedom of judiciary. Now the another question that could be asked would be like, how judiciary has taken a back step in not protecting the fundamental rights of the people. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.